is the truth behind India's honey? How pure is the honey made by your favorite brand? Are you eating nature's wonder food, or are the companies selling you cheap and unhealthy sugar? To find these answers, let us look at the latest report by the Delhi-based Center for Science and Environment, or CSE. CSE has earlier exposed pesticides in colas and packaged drinking water, antibiotics in honey, GMOs in packaged food, and excess salts and trans fat in junk foods. This latest investigation from CSE exposes top Indian brands of selling adulterated honey, honey with sugar syrup. CSE got 22 samples from 13 Indian brands tested first in Indian laboratory and then in Germany. Tests found that more than 77% were not honey, but adulterated with sugar syrup. Only 5 of the 22 samples were found to be unadulterated. The investigation is not just about adulteration. It is about how nefarious the business of adulteration is, that sugar syrups are designed by Chinese companies to pass all Indian tests. This is why CSE sent samples first to an Indian laboratory and then for advanced tests to Germany. These honey samples underwent 2 sets of tests, one in India and one in Germany. The samples of all the 13 Indian honey brands were first sent for laboratory tests to the Center for Analysis and Learning in Livestock and Food at the National Dairy Development Board in Gujarat. This is a state-of-the-art facility for testing food products, including honey, for all parameters set by Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, or FSSAI. Globally, like India, honey is defined as a natural sweet substance produced by honeybees after collecting the plant nectar. If adulterants like sugar syrup or rice syrups are mixed, it can no longer be called honey. And to detect these added sugar syrups, there are a set of complicated tests that every sample of honey has to undergo. FSSAI has mandated 6 sets of tests to detect adulteration. These tests are done to detect 2 types of sugar adulterants called C3 and C4. C3 sugars are found in starchy plants like rice and beetroot, whereas C4 sugars are derived from plants like sugarcane and corn. These sugars and their traces must not exceed a certain threshold for honey to be called pure. We sent a sample from each of the 13 brands to CALF to check for C3 and C4 sugar adulteration. The brands that were part of the study are market leaders like Dabur, Patanjali, Zandu, Saffola, Baidyanath, Apis, Mark Fed Sona and Hitkari, and smaller brands like Nature's Nectar, Dadev, High Honey, Indigenous Honey and Society Natural Honey. Interestingly, the CALF laboratory in India did not find adulteration of C3 and C4 sugar in big brands. However, most of the smaller brands failed the laboratory tests for Indian standards. These smaller brands were adulterated with cane or C4 sugars in most cases. But the picture changed when all the samples were sent to a top laboratory in Germany for advanced testing. The results from the German laboratory told us that Indian standards for honey purity cannot catch adulteration. Meanwhile, Chinese manufacturers were openly advertising in online marketplaces like Alibaba.com and TradeIndia.com about rice and sugar syrups that could bypass the tests for C3 and C4 sugars. There were also rumors that this Chinese technology of masking syrups had reached India, and factories in Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, and Uttarakhand were making them. Were the big brands adulterating this new age magic syrup in their honey? To get around this, one has to rely on a more advanced testing technology called NMR, or nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. NMR is the best available technology today to detect adulteration, especially in honey. It is often called the gold standard for honey testing. All honey from India which is exported must undergo this test. But this test is not mandatory for the honey that is sold in India. These same brands were again tested using the NMR technique. An additional test called TMR, or trace marker for rice syrup, was also conducted on the samples in a German laboratory. And the results were not just surprising, but looked very different. So what were the results? Many samples that had passed the Indian laboratory tests failed on trace marker for rice or TMR. Almost all samples sent to the German laboratory failed the NMR tests. The analysis done by the German laboratory indicates adulteration or addition of sugar syrups in the failed samples. 77% of the Indian brands, including big names like Dabur, Patanjali, Zandu, Baidyanath, Hitkari, and one sample of Nature's Nectar, failed in the NMR testing. Some of these, such as Dabur, Patanjali, Hitkari, even failed the TMR that indicates unauthorized addition of rice syrup, a C3 sugar syrup. But these went undetected in the Indian tests on C3 sugars. The biggest names in the Indian honey business are selling adulterated honey, adulterated with syrups, either made from sugar or rice. Of all the samples, only three brands, Saffola, Mark Fredsona, and Nature's Nectar, passed the tests. From a batch of 22, only 5 passed. This is the mother of all food frauds. This is about your health. You need to know and take charge. To know more about adulteration in honey, visit downtoearth.org.in.